Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who's one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff tunes the cheek region to allow for puffing.
Next will be the puffers, which is kind of the cheek puffing part, and if you move those by default, you see they grab a bit too much. So do a quick fix on that. And that's actually just a map, it's a region and a map. If you click on the region for the puffer here, you'll notice that you don't have the same options. It's just a curve and a multiplier. You don't get the painting. And the reason is you have a specific map for that. So back under the maps, you have puffer paint, puffer mute paint, and this is actually a muting map, so you want to paint the parts you don't want to have affected. And the easiest thing I found is to just dial up 180 degree brush, 100%, and just paint the whole head. And that way you're assured that all the little inner mouth and eyelids and everything is muted from that. So just start with completely muted head, so these controllers won't do anything anymore. So the next thing would be to either bring in a mocap pose or pose these in a logical place for, you know, cheek being puffed out. And let's just key that there. And I'll just copy that value and put it over on this other one. Key that. Let me get the animation off of these. So now you have your puffers that do nothing. So in the extreme pose there, you can just kind of start pulling some of that map back out. So let me pull that down to like 10% or so. Back to 90 degrees, and then just kind of start subtracting that map to get it back to where you want it, and you can kind of start shaping that a little bit. So you can kind of shape your puff with this a bit. Smooth it out. Now, I don't try and make this look like someone's puffing their cheeks out as hard as they can. I use this more as just, you know, air passing through the mouth, so you just a little bit of an inflation as people are talking. To get a really extreme, you know, puffed out, holding your breath look, you have to do a little more work and actually sculpt the stuff exactly like that, probably. But most shots don't need that kind of expression, so I don't really worry about that too much. I just try and get this tuned up for a nice kind of air passing effect. And you want to be a little bit careful that you don't subtract too much from the mouth corners, because that will start to override the mouth operator. It's one of the few things that can kind of demand control over the mouth. So you just want to don't get too close into that stuff. And when you're happy with that, that's it. And then you can kind of do the same thing with your regions and control, you know, exactly how much strength and the kind of range it works within. And one difference to notice here is that you have a negative value as well. So not only can this cheek have a range this way, it can go in. So I can pull that way in, and then with that curve you can control how much in it's allowed to go. So you can use that as well to kind of make sure you don't collide with the teeth. And then you can copy and paste those also.